Live.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whenever and wherever you are listening. Welcome to episode 65 of the Dadbod Golf Pod, proudly a member of the Believe Podcast Network, number one podcast network for professionals. I'm your host, Nate Pass, with me, as always, thank goodness, Kyle Rush and Ben Taylor in Zoom studio with us. Welcome, fellas. The microphones are hot. The dad bods are full. You guys probably had a light beer along with your burger this evening.
No.
On the grill, medium rare. What's up?
Just soda.
Little Coke Zero for the.
That's not a diet soda, Benjamin.
It's a zero. It's a zero, baby. Cherry Coke Zero.
Hey, whoa. We got it. They're not paying for that bar.
Yeah, take that off. Rip off the thing.
Take that label off.
Sorry.
Yep.
Rip it off. This label off. My bad.
Hey, how's everybody doing? Something. Never do it for free.
It's hump day. Sorry. It's hump day, guys. We got tee times to set up this weekend. We got to get focused. We got to get
everybody. They're set, my friend. They are set.
We got to get everybody through the hump day, get it on the downslide to the weekend. And I'm in no better way than my favorite day of the week, my favorite show of the week, maybe my favorite show ever, topics, the Would You Rather Wednesday.
Would you rather.
With Nate leading the charge. Come on. Let's go.
How much do you want to bet that Ben is going to pull some crap that may, I told him earlier, I said, if I hear that's not in the rules, I will take this microphone right here through the wall right in front of me. Paid to paint it not that long ago.
Hey, the odds are high. The odds are probably pretty high. You could probably get a good value on it. You know where else the odds are high? That is at betonline.ag. Head to their website, use your mobile device, sign up today.
You know where else 50, Ben loses?
50% welcome bonus. Ben is already blew through his free play.
Oh, there's no doubt.
He gave him $100. They gave him 50 back. He blew through the 50, but he still had fun. He used Ofer. coupon code Believe, BLEAV. You got baseball, basketball, golf, boxing, casino games, MMA, soccer, live betting, anything you can dream of, they got it. They have the odds. They have the best odds in the game. Don't wait to take advantage of this amazing offer. BetOnline is the fastest and easiest way to bet every single one of your favorite sports. BetOnline, where the game starts. Gentlemen, let's go.
Al, do you think that Ben's one of those guys that like put in 20 and got 10 more and then bets $2 on a game and is still screaming at the TV?
There's no doubt I'm a $2 better. There is no doubt. I put way more in there than I should because I'm afraid I'm going to lose it. And I got a good reason why. I mean, I went 0-3 last weekend with the guys that I want. I was feeling really bad about myself going 0-3 since one guy never showed up, another guy WD'd, and then the third guy just got cut. And then I was listening to some talk radio with the radio stations that I work for. And one of the guys was bragging about how he went 0-10 on the weekend. And I was like, I feel a whole lot better about my life right now. Yeah, he went 0-10 on the weekend. I feel a whole lot better about my life.
Well, if you want to feel better about your life, why don't we get into Would You Rather Wednesday?
This time.
Presented by the Dadbod Golf Pod. All right, everybody, take a couple deep breaths. And remember that we're all friends. But friends, until Ben suspended at this moment till the end of the episode. I'll be friends with you guys afterwards.
We're friendlies now.
All right. Number one topic for Would You Rather Wednesday. You can caddy for the top money winner on the PGA Tour for 5 years. You caddy for him every single event, top money winner, 5 years. Or you are a player, PGA Tour player, for 5 years, and you finish exactly 175th on the money list every single year, which gets you into the next year. Not technically a full schedule, like a 125, but you keep your card for 5 years at 175 on the money list, or caddy for the top number one money list winner for 5 years. Benjamin,
anybody know what kind of money the 175 guy makes?
Benjamin Taylor, these questions were sent to you hours ago. If you don't know how to Google something, I can't help you. But usually you have some crazy, wacky, mixed up answer
So don't even ask stuff like that.
I don't have a mix up. I'm pretty as soon as you gave this one, I was like, this is an easy one for me.
Go ahead.
What is it?
I'm gonna be the player because I get to play. Instead of toting somebody's clubs, I get to play. And even that 175 guy may get paired up with a Tiger every now and then, or the Phil every now and then, at least in one of the first 2 days. Not necessarily on the last two, because I'm finishing at 175 year in and year out. So, like, if I got a choice to play or work, I'm going to play. Mm. So I'm going to go with being the player, even though I have zero chance of ever finishing anywhere close to getting a top 10 finish, to getting a top 50 finish.
You might. You have to win money at some point.
Yeah, you got
to be 175. You got to make a few cuts.
You got to make a few cuts. Yeah. But still, I would love to go back. I doubt any of them have got a win on their card at 175.
I don't know. We'd have to look at that. Ben, I actually did do research, so let me give you the numbers.
Oh, I see.
Oh, man.
You should have let him go first. I knew
175. 175 on the money.
Made his kids do it.
Was 400K this year on the dot. So just say the number one money list winner was 7.7 mil.
I mean, that's taking a little bit of a haircut, Kyle. I admit I'm taking a little bit of a
yeah.
Let me tell you, is it my turn to answer? You're getting
scalped. But yes,
but
Kyle,
I'm only getting on. What's my percentage that I'm getting of that 7. Whatever million?
Probably
as a caddy?
At minimum 10. So my turn. It's my turn. It's my time to shine. Give me the bag right now.
I knew this
caddy.
Yes, he's
I want to win majors. I want to win money. 7 points. Give me 750K minimum in friendship for 5 years. Are you kidding me? That's $1.5 million in difference over the guy that just jacks it around and wins 400K a year. No, it's no big deal. No, but give me the bag. Let's go have friendship with the number one player in the world.
Hey, look, I got a hell of a personality. I got a good sponsor going in the background. All right,
you'll have Flex Seal. You'll be sponsored by like Flex Seal. You
or Testrol, like
Roto Rooter,
Reese's and
Payroll Inc. or something.
Yeah.
And Jim Furyk had like Reese's and Strix on 1 year. That's what you have.
You're gonna be sponsored by Nerf. Like Nerf guns are gonna sponsor you.
I'll be sponsored by one of those financial institutions.
I got him.
Sponsored by Ram wedges. That's
yeah.
What
be sponsored by one of those financial institutions nobody's ever heard of. From
over you're gonna be sponsored by like Kia instead of like Mercedes or Lexus.
Yeah,
you're gonna be sponsored by Hyundai.
Not that there's anything
sponsored
wrong with
by
Hyundai.
Mercury.
Oh gosh, I can't breathe.
Listen, were you guys? I got to say, I didn't play very well today. Could you visit your local Mercury dealer today? Would be greatly appreciative of it.
Is Mercury even a brand? Like, is that even a thing?
Used to be. It used to be.
It's not anymore. That's all right.
You should be driving a Pontiac courtesy car.
Yeah.
And just ripping Slazengers down the fairway.
No doubt.
No, give me the bag. I want the bag. I want to take the money and run. I'll take, like I said, 750 minimum. I'll take that every year. That has to be exhilarating to have that, to have those experiences, because you know your guys are going to have some wins and you're going to be a part of it. You're never going to have a chance to win. You're probably just going to be have anxiety all the time and this, that, or, you know, have anxiety and trying to, trying to keep your card. But I would take the bag for 5 years, and then whatever happens after that happens for sure.
Yeah.
You go home at that 5 years. You go home. That's all we get.
And you can play as much golf as your heart desires. And but if you, after 5 years of 175, you're going to put the clubs away. I mean, it's just going to be miserable.
Maybe you.
But anyway, Nate, Passion Microphone's hot. Thank you. I'm definitely taking the bag. So $7.7 million was like the lowest first place money winner in the last 5 years. I went 5 years back. I did that. We had a few of them at 9. Spieth made $12 million in 2015. I did a little research on how caddies get paid. I wasn't just pulling it out of my butt, you know. It's usually depends on if it's a top 10, if it's a win, if it's outside the top 10. Most guys get a little salary every week. My best guess, if you average out the top five, last 5 years of the number one money winner, you're looking around 550 to 600 grand a year, and you're going to be in those moments. You're going to be in those playoffs. You're going to be on the green on 18 at Augusta with a chance to win. You're going to be hugging him. Listen, and most of these caddies work 30 weeks a year.
I'm going to be in that position too, except I'm going to have the club in my hands. I'm just going to lose.
No, you're not going to be in a position.
You've already been driving. You literally just said
at the beginning when I said I have no chance of winning. You're like, oh yeah, you do.
No, you don't have a chance of winning. One win. I'm saying you said top. You've got to get a handful of top 25s, and then you just make like 12 cuts. That's your life.
Okay.
You get a couple backdoor. Excuse me. Also,
okay, Caddy.
You make 400 grand a year. You got to pay people. You got to pay that guy to carry your back.
Ooh, that's a good point too.
You know, and listen, I will commend you, Ben, because you clearly didn't do this for money. Either that, or you're really bad at math. But you didn't.
No. I knew I wasn't doing it for money.
And you know what? Me and Kyle sold ourselves down the river.
There's no doubt.
And I couldn't be happier about it. Couldn't be happier about it.
So number one,
give me the bag.
Number 175 on the money list this year was Peter Uihlein.
See
that. At 400,000. I'm never.
See, also,
does he have any wins?
I'm gonna.
I don't think
I'm
that's important. I think he has a PGA Tour card, and you two caddies do not.
But
I'm gonna step out here.
He can have it. He can have it.
I'm gonna step out here and say that the endorsements that I could get as the most recognizable caddy in the world would be equal to, if not greater than, your payroll.
Oh,
or your Nerf.
Come on.
Or maybe like the country restaurant from where you are back home, like, gives you free meal a week.
Hilardas.
You guys are under the impression that number one's going to let your caddyhood.
You're going to get like battery swords.
Overshadow them being number one. There's no chance.
Caddies are big now, Ben. Caddies
get sponsors.
Caddies are in. Caddies are in. Caddies are becoming.
They are winners in your own mind. They are.
But Ben, what I want you to do is I want you to come up to me on the putting green on Thursday morning, and I want you to speak. You know, and you won't be able to talk to my guy. I don't want him mingling with 175, but I do want you to speak. I still want to be friends.
Oh, let me tell you something. If you want friends, friends forever, you want friends for just generations, then you will check out Swannies.co, because everybody wants to be a friend to the guy wearing anything.
Yes.
From Swannies.co. Use coupon code DadBod-GolfBod-25. Take 25% off your order. Load up the cart. Load it up. You got all season covered. You got summer covered. You got winter covered. You got fall covered with pullovers. You got heavy jackets. You got light jackets. You got heavy vests. You got light vests. You got short sleeves, long pants, short pants, everything.
Short pants.
Yes. Shorts.
Shorts.
Capris. I guess that's what I meant. Shorts. They got it all. Swannies.co. Love them. They're awesome. You guys need
the legend shirt.
The legend shirt's great. The Hef polo is awesome. I have the Hef. That's my favorite shirt.
Yeah, I love this new trend of like naming polos. Yeah. Like instead of it's just like
we're gonna have a polo. By the way,
we're gonna have a dad bod polo. We've got to have.
And
a
you can't get it any size smaller than large. Like it doesn't come in medium or small.
Nope.
Yeah,
if you're a little guy and you order one, it's gonna swallow you whole. You can just forget it. You have
a little bit tapered in the belly area. It's gonna be tapered in the belly area for a little bit.
Accentuate the ideal dad bod.
Exactly. Okay. Swannies.co. Let's go. Question number two
for Would You Rather Wednesday. This is a bit of an open-ended question, which is terrifying when Benjamin Taylor is involved in the discussion. We are going to go out on a limb here, and if it doesn't work out, that could be the end of any open-ended question on Would You Rather Wednesday again. So we're going to start off with Ben, just in case we need to jump all over him and smother him. Eliminate a golf rule, Benjamin. Just pick one. Just one.
Say you don't eliminate one. I say we add one. I'm just kidding.
My heart rate just spiked. If I was wearing Whoop right now, you would have seen it go up.
150
I'd have been up there with Justin Thomas on the first tee.
You got to throw in gimmies. Everybody ought to have gimmies now. Quit making people putt 2-inch putt. No, I'm just kidding. That's not it. Mine is eliminating the mud ball from the fairway. If a guy hits the ball in the fairway off the tee and he has a mud ball, he should not be forced to hit said mud ball into the green where it could go just absolutely anywhere. He's being penalized for actually doing his job and hitting a tee shot down the middle of the fairway. And just because that it's rained the night before, or maybe the grounds crew got a little zealous with the watering in the morning before they all came out there. And so now they're sitting out there and they got a mud ball while the guy that hit it over in the fescue, in the trample down fescue where the people have been walking, has no mud on his ball and he's got a clean lie and he's not being penalized for it.
Seems so, like you went to the vault there, Ben. I think you went to the vault for a memory. Was that a memory? Oh, well, yeah, shout out to Colin Morikawa.
It could be. So that is my thing. You got to get rid of the mud ball in the fairway. And that goes, and some people have said, oh, so you're just asking they do lift, clean, and play. No. I mean, if you get to your ball and you notice there's no mud on it, you don't lift, clean, and place. Now, I will say, are there going to be some that take advantage of that where they're like, oh, I see a little bit of mud on there, so let's lift, clean, and place it.
But here's the thing about the fairway is that's supposed to be the reward. Like, who cares?
That's my thing.
There shouldn't be a bad lie in the fairway. No. So if you lift, clean, and place, it shouldn't be an advantage.
No.
Yeah, I'm with you. If you hit a ball on the fairway, you should never be penalized whatsoever.
I'm going to be a little bit of a contrarian here. I'm going to be because it's a slippery slope. What if your ball hit a tree and then it bounced into the fairway? Like, being
that's
in the
just,
fairway
that's
doesn't
just good luck.
It's just bad luck that you get mud on your
more,
ball.
Like, more than likely, if it does that, then the velocity is not where it's going to gather mud on the ball if it's bouncing off a tree and then jumps into the fairway. Or if it kicks out of the lip of the sand and then goes into the fairway, then you're probably not having mud on the ball because it just skirts into the fairway. But when you hit a bomb down there and it lands in the fairway and bounces and you got a big glob of mud on the side of it, you ought not to be penalized and you ought to be able to wipe that crap off and hit your ball into the green.
What if you smoke one down the middle and it hits a sprinkler head and it bounces into the rough and then you have mud on it? Like, you did everything you were supposed to do and you just got a bad break. Like,
you
just
answered the question.
I think bad breaks are part of golf.
That's not a bad break when you hit it in the middle of the fairway.
I'm saying, what if you like hit it in the middle of the fairway and it hits the sprinkler head and it bounces into the rough or behind
a
tree or into a bunker or into the water?
Then you can't clean it. It's in the rough. It's a rough ball.
I think it's a slippery slope. You start letting guys wipe mud balls off in the fairway. You're going to start letting them get free drops if it hits a turtle and goes into the water?
Yes.
It's a slippery slope.
Wait, there's a local rule for that. I think we read that local rule a while back.
Slippery slope.
I think
give an inch, take a mile.
No, slippery slope. No, I just think that at that point in time, we got to be able to make rational decisions. And come on, like, if you hit the ball in the middle of the fairway, there's no reason you should ever be penalized. Let's just stop it.
Players have got to be trustworthy too, though, Kyle, because you can't have to call an official over every single time that happens.
But my point is, in the fairway,
you
should be able to touch your ball regardless, because you can't. There's, in theory, you can't improve your lie in the fairway.
Right.
It's the best. Like, that, it's the best. It can't be any better. You hit it in the best place. So even if you pick up a ball that doesn't have mud on it, when you place it back down, you should not be in a better position than you were before. So, no, I'm saying, let's go. Let it. Do whatever you want to do in the fairway.
Did you want that to be your rule too? You
want to
do a different one? Okay, gotcha.
Mine's very similar. If the fact that we make people hit out of divots, honestly, anywhere on the course, but especially in a fairway, that is absolute ludicrous. Absolute lunacy that we make people hit out of divots. Like, this is 1869 or whatever it is, whenever golf was invented. Come on, guys. There's no reason in the middle of the fairway that you should ever have to hit out of a divot. That is the most asinine rule that has ever been made. That part of golf is so stupid. That is the stupidest part about golf. I don't care. Oh, if we had to do it in the 70s. Oh, we walked in the snow barefooted uphill. But I don't care what you did in the 70s. It was stupid then. It's stupid now. Let's stop hitting out of divots. I would say divots anywhere, but divots especially, because even in the rough, oh, yeah, you hit it in the rough. Well, you hit it in the rough. You didn't hit it in a divot. You know what I mean? Like, that's not meant to have just divots over there. Anytime you hit it in a divot, it ought to be able to be moved, but especially in the fairway when you're supposed to be rewarded for a good shot. I'm out of breath. Nate, let's go.
Okay, so before I play the contrarian here, the type of golf I play, we move it, we roll it everywhere.
We do.
Put a club on it, you can swing it. But that being said, PGA Tour golf, playing by the rules, the fairway is not just some free pass to do whatever you want.
The whole golf course is in play. I'm just going to be a contrarian here for just a second, devil's advocate for just a second. The whole golf course is in play. Because you hit in the fairway doesn't mean you get this, like, free pass.
Now I'm getting riled up.
Whatever you want versus the guy who hit it in the rough or hit it in the sand or hit it in the woods. Yes, you get a good lie. You get the short grass. You usually have the best angle from the fairway. The fairway does not give you some free pass to just do whatever you want to do.
It's not a free pass. It legit, they're going against their own rules where it's a man-made object. It is a man-made obstruction that they have just put in the fairway because it did not get fixed. A bunch of squirrels didn't come create those divots overnight.
It's not an obstruction. Didn't just put a tree there.
It totally is an obstruction. If they take a huge divot and you've got to get up out of that divot without being able to make a proper swing on the ball, it's obstructed between the hole and the ball.
What about a footprint in the fairway? I mean, where do we stop?
That goes back to mud on the ball,
lift, clean, and place. Or a guy sticks the bag in the fairway.
You should be able to lift, clean, and place anywhere in the fairway. You should be rewarded. When you see guys now that are actually, they're like, the fairway sucks today because it's wet. I can't lift, clean, and place. See where all those people are standing over there? I'm hitting over there because I got a better chance of catching some trample ground grass than I do hitting it out in the middle of the fairway. That's dumb.
It's like Bryson. That is
so dumb.
Bryson at Torrey Pines, just blow it. Number four, just blow it over into the fans.
Look, caused me to do, Nate? Now you got me agreeing with you about frigging Bryson. What are you doing?
It's the first step.
You know what? I try and bring out the best in you, Ben, and right now I've accomplished. I've accomplished what I've set out to be, okay?
Yes.
Unbelievable.
You got me talking good
about Bryson. You got me agreeing with Kyle.
Nate is a coach.
I saw you start to shake down there, and I just kept going. I was done with what I wanted to say, but I kept going. You know why?
Because I want zero you to cherry. I didn't bring beer tonight, so now I'm really screwed because I can't even partake in that. This is ridiculous.
Yep. Yeah, you're drinking zero cherry.
What's your answer?
This is just because I think guys look absolutely ludicrous doing it.
Hitting out of divots?
I know. That's just take what the game gives you. If life gives you lemons in a divot, then
The game didn't give you that.
Yes, it did.
Ian Woosnam did out in front of me because he took a divot.
Ian Woosnam, what tour are you playing on? You playing on that European senior tour? Ian Woosnam.
Wow. What's your rule, Nate?
I want guys to stop crouching over and dropping the ball from their knee because the coolest people on the planet, these elite golfers, look like complete idiots. I don't care if you drop it above your head from your armpit. I don't care if you toss it in the air and spin around three times. Do not bend it over and drop it from your knee. No ball comes in at any angle from knee height. Stupidest rule.
I'm so glad you said that. And I hate to always take something back to Bryson, but I listened to a podcast recently and it started off very extreme, but then it made a lot of sense. So he was talking about how the softer your shot, the softer you strike a ball, the dimples, if you catch a dimple wrong, it can send the ball offline. So think about this. When you drop a ball up high, it just stops. Like it doesn't go crazy, but when you drop that ball at your knee really soft, it just goes all over the place. It's not realistic. It's not realistic. I agree. Why did we even do that? Go ahead, get it up there, drop it. It's not like if it bounces offline, they just place it anyway.
They drop it twice and then they just place it. Yeah.
That's stupid in and of itself. Like just that we do that. Like if it moves.
How about the PGA Tour double down too? Because the players after the first year of doing it, they were all complaining about it because of what Nate said. They said, we look stupid doing this. This is absolutely stupid.
And they just all forgot. Yeah.
So they approached the PGA Tour and they were like, we're okay with doing the knee thing. Let's just do it anywhere above the knee. So if we just want to take a ball and just drop it from our waist or drop it from waist, like where we're used to, whatever.
That has to be above your knee.
Has to be above your knee. And the PGA Tour was like, you know what? We like you looking stupid. We're going to keep this rule in.
Yeah.
That's true.
I hate watching a 6'6" Dustin Johnson lean over and try and drop a ball from his knee. And like,
I don't hate that, Nate.
It looks like he's trying to look at something on the low shelf of the grocery store.
I hate that the fact that they have to look up. Yeah. They have to look up at the PGA Tour official that's with them, and they're like, "Is this okay? Is this okay?" And the PGA Tour official, you'll even see something a little bit lower, a little bit low. Okay, now you're good to drop. And it's like, bro,
are you 100% sure? Are you 100%?
Don't Yeah, it's like, don't tell me two holes ago that I'm on the clock, and now we've wasted 45 seconds for you to tell me the exact angle that I need to drop this ball from above my knee. Come on, please.
All right, impromptu question, grocery store. Ready? Lower shelf cereal that you loved growing up. Mine was Fruit Wheels. What is yours?
Honey Smacks.
Well, that's a good one.
Huge Honey Smacks guy.
I don't remember what the name of the fake Captain Crunch was, whatever that was.
It was like Admiral Crunch.
Yeah, the Admiral Crunch or whatever it was. The fake Captain Crunch.
And if my parents
did you say all... Fruit Wheels?
Fruit Wheels.
He remembers them. Yeah.
Look it up. If we brought home cereal in a bag, it was just so deflating.
Yeah, that's bad.
My parents were big into that. I just because my parents never would buy it when we were at the store the other day, I got me some Boo Berry cereal for Halloween.
Send it to them? But
I did send him a picture. I said, look what I'm old enough to get now.
Also,
I'm going to eat the whole box myself tonight.
A sidebar. What was it about growing up when we go down the cereal aisle, we just absolutely lost our freaking minds?
Oh, dude.
Because we had toys, man. They don't do the toys as much as they used to.
The packaging is so good. Yeah, you got the spoon that would change colors when it got cold. And it's just, it's so beautifully done. Like, there's all these colors. These boxes are all the exact same size. And then I promise I'll eat it. You get past the cereal and boom, Pop-Tarts. What's up? I mean, it is the most magical aisle in the grocery store.
It really is. I'm so upset now that they've gone all academic on me with the cereal. Like, they don't give you the toys. They got like stuff for you to solve on the back. No, get that out of here. Listen, give me a Dakota ring. Yeah, I'm getting up and having breakfast at like 4 a.m. Like, even at my age, I'm not solving puzzles.
You're still staring
back to the box, though. Yeah, I'm not solving puzzles.
Quick sidebar within the sidebar within the sidebar. You used to work at Publix.
Yes, and you did.
You call it fronting. It's like when you get everything right there on the front edge. You get all the cereal boxes, like, dead even. And it is the most tedious aisle on the whole grocery store to do it because everything has to line up perfectly. But I tell you what, you get to the end of a cereal aisle, and then you get to the done, and then a lady comes and grabs, like, three boxes, make you want to pull your hair out, let me tell you. Whole thing's fronted perfect, you know, and then she just grabs some Honey Smacks and Captain Crunch. Anyway,
what a bad person.
Huge rabbit trail there. Astronomical rabbit trail.
Speaking of, we gotta
pull ourselves up by our bootstraps. Go ahead.
Speaking of bagged cereal, sweetrollsgolf.com is the place to go for
speaking of sweet wheels. What'd you call them? Fruit wheels. Speaking of
bagged cereal.
Look at that fruit wheel right there, baby.
Let me tell you what's way cooler than bagged cereal, and that's a grip from sweetrollsgolf.com. Use coupon code DADBOD20. Take 20% off your order. Throw that bagged cereal in the garbage. Get your putter wrapped. Start feeling good, looking good, rolling it good. It's guaranteed to take 2 to 3 strokes off your game. And if it doesn't, you suck. It's not the putter grip's fault. Let's go. Get in the game. We all have one. We all love it. We all putt fairly decent now. Let's do it. Moving on to the last question.
The third would you rather Wednesday topic.
Hey, before we get there, I'm getting Count Chocolate this weekend. Just so you know.
You're getting what?
Count Chocula cereal.
Count Chocula. Nice.
I did Boo Berry, so I'm going Count Chocula this time. Okay, go ahead. Number three.
Cool, man. Okay, number three. Wow. I'm so glad you told us that.
you're getting married. I got to try to match up, man.
You can play your home course only. That's it. So the course that you played, no, don't try and
this is
like,
the one
oh, I played Augusta one time, so it's like my home course. Okay. The course that you would play more often than any other course.
I'm literally from Augusta, Nate. Why can I not pick that? I'm just kidding. I'm not.
Yeah, you're not from Augusta. You're not Justine's sister.
Then you can have Augusta Country Club that's like right beside. Don't
you shut your mouth.
You can play your home course only. That's it. You never play another course ever. Your buddy's going on a trip. Any other opportunity, or you can play any course in the world for free. Any course in the world, free of charge. Accommodations not included. But you got to play it from the tips. All the way back, every time.
Every round for the rest of your life.
Every round, the rest of your life.
When you're 60, 70, playing golf, you got to play from the tips.
Don't care. So we're going to start off with chocolate, Dracula, whatever.
Count Chocula. Count Chocula.
Nice. Can't wait for you to eat that this weekend. Benjamin, go ahead.
It's going to really upset my playing partners when I get to be 72 years old and I'm still playing from the tips for absolutely free because I don't care. I am there for the course because it's in, you said it's in, am I getting the rules correct? It's any course in the world.
That's right.
Yeah. There's no doubt in my mind that I'm doing that. I don't care if I'm, I mean, if I'm able to swing the club, it's just going to make my playing partners really pissed off at me because I'm just going to be puttering around out there, but I don't care. Because
it's probably going to be hard to have a lot of playing partners.
But yeah, and that's
they got to pay for it because they got to pay for it.
That's fine though. I mean, you go to like some resort and I get paired up, then they're really going to be ticked off because they have no idea who I am and they're going to be wondering why in the world I'm 82 and playing from the tips.
All your games are going to be screwed up. Like you're going to have.
I don't care. I mean, the fact that I can play for free any course, the free part sticks out. But number two, just being able to play some of the most magnificent courses in the world. I mean, that's absolutely fabulous. And even though you got to play from the tips, that is going to kind of suck though on some of those where I'm going to have to take some drops. I got a feeling there's going to be some.
You're going to smoke a drive with everything you've got down the pipe.
You're going to have 260 in on a par four.
Or drop because you can't clear the 275 yard ditch.
I played Kiowa from the tips, the ocean course. And number two, all right, I parred number one, hit a good drive down the fairway, parred at number two.
Shout out.
Is a par five, and it's 270 to the fairway into the wind and did not get it to the fairway. That is no fun whatsoever. Is it my turn?
Ben, Kyle, no, go ahead.
No, but it is your show.
I'm sure Ben will have some more to say.
The best part about golf is friendship. It's that game, that Thursday, Friday, 2-2, no max press. Though that camaraderie, I love it. And you can play from wherever you want to for the rest of your life. If you're good enough, you can play from the tips. If you hurt your back, you can play from the whites. If you feel a little squirrely, you go play the orange. You do whatever you want to do, but you're going to have your buds from your club that you're going to get to play with forever. And you don't have to go like what it's not fun to go play somewhere knowing you're probably going to shoot like 120 because it's a 7,800 yard course. Who cares if it's the plantation course in Kapalua that's, you know, you got 500 yard par fours that play dead into the wind and you got to play. I mean, I don't want any part of that.
I know it's okay if you don't want to challenge yourself.
If I want to play from back there, I will.
You just want it for free, Ben.
But I want that option.
No doubt.
I want that option to play wherever I want. I want friendship. If I can't imagine.
You know how many friends I can make playing those courses?
You're going to go to a course and you can't even, you're going to have to play basically separate from your group. You can't even play the same game. They're like, okay, Ben's playing from the tip or I'm playing from the tip. So we'll give you six extra strokes. It's just dumb. It's dumb.
You're not going to make any friends, Ben. People are going to know. Nobody's going to make friends with you.
You've seen my personality.
I don't want to play first tee. Everybody's going to be like, okay, yeah, going back to the tips. Oh, 230 yard slight slice. Cool. Could be a long day. We're going to play on through, buddy. You can play by yourself.
Yeah, exactly. That's what you're going to be. Give me friendship. Give me the Friday 2-2 at 2. 2-2 at 2. Let's go. I'll take that for the rest of my life.
Hokey. So generic.
I think I've already given it away. Nothing ruins playing a course that you've never played before that you're excited about playing that must be, it might be really cool, really scenic. Than playing like crap, okay? Nothing ruins it worse than that. So, from the tips, beautiful course. Oh, cool, I've got 212 yards into every single par four. No, zero fun, sir. Over the last 5 years, I've probably played a very minuscule amount of rounds outside my home course, and I love it. I love my course. I love my homies. I love the white tees. It's $20 a pop. The money's not a big issue. Give me AU club five ever. Means the world to me in every way possible. Not going to get emotional.
Oh my gosh.
And hey, FaceTime me from Pebble.
You guys when are you're so shooting drinking 193.
This is fun. This is a funny story. This is another sidebar. One time me and Nate played, and we're playing with a dude who was practicing for the club championship. And he's like, let's all play from the tips. And I was like, oh, it'll be fun. Right, Nate? It'll be fun. We played the front nine, and we're like, screw this. We played from the whites.
We'll adjust the bet, but we're going to play the whites on the back.
Yeah, it was great. Shot 2 under on the back. I love that. That was awesome. No, but
that was a fun day.
What a terrible story.
Friendship, man. You can't beat friendship. And you're going to be the scourge of the earth when you go to these places and they're like, this dude is going to shoot 120 from the tips and we got to play with him. That's going to be, because he won't come up and play with us. That is awful. I don't even want
to
be this guy.
Gives me a topic of conversation to talk to them about once we get up to the green.
Talk about, at the green, like, they're going to be sitting there waiting for you.
Like, you're gonna be on the clock.
On the tee box. You're probably so what happens if there's like a long wait on the tee box? Do you just kind of like go back to the tip?
It's not my fault that you guys want to take the easy way out. I mean, that's fine. If you guys don't like a challenge,
we're agreeing to pay for golf for the rest of our lives. We're taking a financial sacrifice.
If you don't like a challenge,
Ben, how? I mean,
if you don't like a challenge in your life, that's fine.
When you're 75, you're gonna go play a course from 7,600 yards just because it's you can go play whatever
game.
Yeah,
give up the game.
Why not?
Listen, if I want to challenge myself, AU Club's got a set of blue tees. I play them sometimes. If I hate myself, I like playing a good 18, shoot 74. I know I've done everything I want to do golf wise that day, and then I'll go play 9 for the Blues, shoot 41, and drink.
I'm at the point now. Maybe that's got something to do with me being older than you guys. I'm at the point where I'd really rather have the experience than playing my own same course over and over and over. I don't care how bad I played. I'd rather have that.
Maybe your course isn't that good.
He does play a pretty good course.
And the really the best thing about you is I'm going to give you the exemption. You play a course that has three courses, so I'm going to allow you to play any of those three courses within this realm. So, yeah. I mean, you know, we just if you want one, a challenge, you could play, you know, the tips from the short course.
All I'm saying is the guys play them all out there working when it gets time for them to play golf, they go somewhere else because they'd rather have a challenge somewhere else, whatever.
Yeah, go
Working there is a whole different ballgame. Working there is a whole different ballgame. I mean, you don't hang out like at the radio station and eat lunch if you're off, right?
Are you kidding me? Yes, yeah. I do.
No. Nobody does that. You get out of there.
Whatever, man.
Give me friendship for life. I want friendship and camaraderie for life.
Aren't you so glad that you and me both chose that, Kyle?
I'm so glad, buddy.
I would never leave you behind like that.
I would never leave you.
Leave no.
You sound like Kyle and Bryson.
We are.
Dude, am I Bryson in this situation?
No, you're – no, up
Kyle and no, Kyle to come to the house and black out.
No.
It you're bombs Kyle. And black out.
Kyle's Bryson. You're worshiping him.
Oh, come on. Come on, Ben. You're mad because you made a bad pick again.
Hey, guys want to grill some steak so we can get some
Good news is we would need – Kyle, what we would need to do is we would need to be able to – you guys keep saying that I'd be shooting 120, 130, 140. There's one way to be able to measure that, by the way.
Yeah, you'd actually be able to know what you actually shot, how you shot it, where you lost shots, and that's arcosgolf.com.
Use off the tee box.
DADBOD10. Take 10% off your next order. Get the system, guys. It's a little sensor system that go in all 14 of your clubs. So if you carry more clubs, this is not for you. If you're a cheater, this one's not for you. You got to have 14 clubs. You screw them in, you link them to the app on your phone, and then you have a Bluetooth clip that you carry on your belt. So you don't have to keep your phone in your pocket. You just put the clip on your belt and you just play golf, and it keeps your strokes gained average off the tee, approach, short game, putting. It tells you where you're losing shots. You know, a lot of times we make emotional decisions. We hit that one out of bounds late when we triple pressed on 17 and we're like, man, my driver really let me down today. But really, maybe your driver was not that bad. Maybe you hit the ball pretty decent off the tee. Maybe it was your strokes into the green from 100 yards that let you down. This thing shows you how to do it. It shows you how to do it, and you don't have to do anything other than screw them in and then go play golf. It's awesome. Top of the notch technology. Maps out all your shots. Love it. A lot of fun. A lot of things you can learn from it. Arcosgolf.com
takes the emotion out of the game.
Takes the emotion out like, of
Kyle and Nate being emotional about playing their home course instead of going somewhere else.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Oh, wow.
Ben used the ad read to somehow diss me and Kyle. Huh. Shocker. Didn't see that coming.
This always ends up happening on a Wednesday. Wednesday. We get mad
Wednesdays
at
are electric. Wednesdays, I'll be friends with Ben mainly again after the show's over. But right now, Ben makes poor decisions.
I can only
make choices that I can't support.
Nate's only friends with me for like 6.5 days a week. Ben, that's all he's friends with me.
Ben makes me steaming angry on Wednesdays. Absolutely shaking with rage.
Because I know Wednesdays. Ben wakes up on Wednesday morning thinking, how in There's the world no doubt. Can I make Nate want to pull his nose hairs out?
How can There's I rustle no Nate's jimmies? No. On a Wednesday.
No. All I'm thinking of, I'm trying to make Kyle laugh. You know, I have the best intentions, pure, clean, Nate, fun.
Nate, the best night of sleep I get is Tuesday night, knowing that come Wednesday, I can get you
right. Jimmy wrestling time.
Whatever,
love it.
Whatever, man. You know what I do is like, when we're about to record this episode, like today, Kyle's like, hey, Nate, you can host it. I was starting thinking about my outfit. Like, I need my outfit to match my energy for hosting.
I like it.
Would you rather Wednesday?
I love it. I love it.
Listen,
wouldn't travel well, but it'd do well on your home course.
Episode 65 in the books. Another Would You Rather Wednesday. We want to hear from you.
Yeah. Oh.
You may have a horrible opinion too.
Him.
You know what? You may think like Ben. You may make poor decisions, and we can't wait to hear about them. So give us a shout out. We've got an email address. We've got a phone number. They'll be in the description. I'm not even going to try and butcher them right now. Rate, subscribe, and review. Leave us reviews. We want to read the funny things. If you want to roast us, don't hold back. We'll read it. Let the whole world laugh at how funny you are. We know
we're
funny.
Shout out Colonel Steve. He's been taking my side most of these Wednesdays. I'm kind of curious where we stand come tomorrow.
Yeah, Colonel Steve.
I got a good guess.
Anyway, subscribe to us on YouTube. Wacky, weird, wild YouTube live. We just need some more subscribers to get that done. Check out all our sponsors. What an amazing episode, boys. Thank you for joining me. I'm your host, Nate Pass. Joined me today, Kyle Rush, Ben Taylor, for episode 65 of the Dadbod Golf Pod.
Always stroking.